Okay, so Carlos, my job is really easy. As we go along and we're cooking tonight, do you see where it says potatoes in the blue sheet? On the table? And then there's a number right next to it?
Mm-hmm.
What number's next to that?
Three.
So that tells me what cone to use when I chop the food up. So your job is going to be to keep me on track as to what I'm supposed to cook and what cone I'm supposed to use, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so let's see. Who wants to first try the machine? Okay, come on up, Corey. Wash your hands. Grab an apron. So the first thing we're going to do is our potatoes, and we're going to chop them up in our church pan. And do you know why we call it a church pan? Because it's holy.
Oh, man.
Oh. So when we use our salad master machine, how many potatoes did you guys say?
14.
That's a lot.
14? Or did you do 10 or 7? Potatoes shrink a lot.
Yeah,
they settle a lot.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to take, I love it, she's a registered dietitian. She's cleaning those hands since she's in the hospital. Likes you guys. Perfect. Okay, so you ready for your lesson? So when you're using the machine, especially when you have a customer use it, you want to turn it so they don't have it. Normally I have it turned so you guys can see the food coming out, but with you I want it straight on. Okay? So we're going to use our number 3 cone, and we're just going to put it in here. And you take the potato. See how my hand, see how this doesn't work?
Mm-hmm.
But see how my hand could be flat on here? So I'm just going to push down and let it go straight down the back. Okay? Then once it stops like that, I'm going to flip. I'm going to put my, everybody hold up your left hand. Pinch your pinky and thumb together. Okay, that anchors on the outside.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And then your fingers go right at the edge, not over because you can't push, right?
Mm-hmm.
But right here, and then you just take it down. Okay? Now I don't push real hard at the end because metal and plastic, who's going to win?
The metal.
Every time, right? So you want to keep not putting metal in there. So that was one potato. Okay? So this one is small enough, it fits right in the back. So you're going to go ahead and take my plates, put your thumb on the outside. Oh, just hand spins.
Oh,
there you go, yeah.
Okay. That is easy.
Push a little harder over here. There you go. It is easy, huh? So if you say things like, isn't that fast? Isn't that easy? That's my job. There we go. Just throw it in there. That'll cook. Okay, we're going to do 3. Oh, wait. Hand flat. There you go. Perfect. Yeah, we've got to go. Awesome. And then we'll put some onion in there. Pretty easy, huh? And we'll just leave any food in there and we'll just throw this. Onions usually make you cry. But in here, there's no more tears for you. Just put it in the back. And it's a great anti-inflammatory food. There you go. The one that, there you go. And push over here on this side. Like this. There you go. And then how you take the food out is give me the thumbs up. Okay? Then we put. We're gonna do it again. So we take our hand on the inside and see how you take the food out. Okay, and then take your right hand, hold it up.
Oh,
just kidding. Okay, but you push that away. See, I'm holding here, and I just push that away. Okay. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna wash that. You see how easy that is to clean?
Yeah.
See how easy my job is. Really, I boss my customers around just like this. I mean, I ask my customers to help just like this. Like that? Awesome. Okay, then over here, potatoes, normally when you cook them, like if you're making potato salad, you boil them.
Mm-hmm.
When you boil them, what does it do to the food?
It's soggy.
Soggy, takes out the nutrition. And it also takes out the starch. Now, because we're not boiling these, we need to take the starch out or they'll turn glassy. So we're simply going to run a little cold water over the potato side. And that'll get rid of a lot of the starch. Because our body takes starch, turns it into glucose, we burn it as energy or store it as fat. So we de-starched our potatoes. Then we take our cover from our 3-quart so we don't drip potato water all over. This is a good training video, by the way. Thank you guys. Okay, and notice that? So I use 3 potatoes, Carlos, compared to how many?
14.
14, so how much did we save? A lot, huh? Mm-hmm. Like percent-wise, that was 80% or something like that? So jot that down under percent saved in the next column. Now, what temperature do we start this on?
Medium.
Okay. This is going to be, for the most delicious broccoli. You can make flavorful cauliflower. You can also do potatoes, artichokes. You guys ever make artichokes?
Mm-hmm.
How do you cook them?
You just steam them.
Yeah. How long does it take? I don't even know. How long does it take?
It actually takes a pretty long time.
It takes a long time.
Yeah, half an hour.
As much as I like them, I don't.
Yeah.
Don't ever do them. Either steam them for like 40 minutes, it seems like, or you boil the life out of them, right? There's that tipping point of good and done.
Yeah.
So these you can take and throw in there, turn them to medium, the valve will click, and they'll be done in about 15 minutes.
Mm.
Everything, and they'll be good too. Everything is half the time when you're cooking, half the cook time. Or you could take hamburger. You ever come home and you're like, your hamburger's frozen?
Mm-mm.
No? Anybody ever have that happen? Like you want to use it for spaghettis or tacos? So, and you go, oh, I can thaw it out. So take it straight out of your freezer, put your hamburger here with the water in the bottom. It'll thaw out your hamburger meat in 15 minutes frozen to finish. Dump the fat down the drain. Save yourself some money because you spend about $2 a pound on meat, right? If it's the extra lean.
Mm-hmm.
So if you buy the lower grade, this will turn it into the higher grade for you. Okay, we ready to fry some chicken? Okay, scooch over this way. So now, in here, whenever you fry, you always have to use oil, right? But do you hear this? So there's oil in there. But it never touches your food. It acts as a heating element, so it's just as hot as the center as it is on the sides. Okay? So whenever you fry, think about it. If you're frying up food, who needs the oil? Does the chicken need the extra fat? No. Do we need the extra fat?
No.
What needs the fat? The pan. Mm. Okay, ready for this skill set? You guys pay close attention. Ready, Stephen? Do you think with a little training you could do that? See how it sticks?
Yeah.
And what's cooking out, Corey?
The water.
Or the?
The fat.
The fat. You guys
see
that? So this is the opposite of old-fashioned cooking. It defats the meat. Right? Instead of absorbing the fat in.
Hmm.
Boy, they pay me good money to do this. If you did that in a regular pan, though, with the oil, what would happen, Carlos?
Yeah.
They would burn. The children would be crying because they would have got burnt. Now, what's up with this? Can we do this?
I don't think so.
So you could do rock hard frozen meat with thawed meat, and it'll cook your rock hard frozen chicken in about 20 minutes. It's not a pan, is it, Delma?
I should see her face. She's like,
really? What would happen if you tried to fry frozen chicken in a regular pan?
It wouldn't cook all the way through. It would like burn on one side.
Well, it would splatter like crazy.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
it would
splatter,
it would burn, and it would
start fire.
Start fire. Yeah. Carlos, they've never called the fire department yet.
No.
So, this, you're going to throw that over the top. And this, if you wanted to bake your chicken, this is how you bake it.
Hmm.
If you want to fry your chicken, this is how you fry it. Okay, I'm going to see if you pass the test. Okay, ready? Close your eyes. What am I doing?
You're frying?
Are you sure? Open your eyes.
You're frying? Now you're baking.
Oh, you're backwards.
Oh, it's the other. Oh, so that's frying and then that's baking.
Okay. Awesome. So this, like lasagna, they could take that salad master machine, prep a lasagna in 5 minutes, bake it oven free here in 20 minutes,
mm-hmm.
and they can get that machine for free.
Hmm.
Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
And they can get this machine for free too, as a bonus for getting their set the first time they see it. So this one is totally immersible in water, dishwasher safe, lifetime warranty. This is an oven. So anything you bake in an oven, you can do right here. So what is something you might bake in an oven?
Cake.
Right here. How long does it take in an oven?
30 minutes or so. 30, 40, depending on the pan.
45. Guess how long it takes in here? Half the time. Okay. What else can we bake in an oven?
Fish.
Ooh, salmon.
Yeah.
So you could take salmon, put it in a cold piece, because if you're baking, you start cold. If you're frying, you start hot. Okay? So put a bed of spinach, a piece of salmon, pesto, and red pepper. It takes 5 minutes to throw together. Cover it. Turn your temperature gauge, right here, onto 275. You see that? And that little valve is going to click. Who remembers what temperature the valve clicks at?
Medium?
85.
Oh, 185.
You start on medium, right? And it clicks at 185, and then you turn it to low. So you turn this down, and it will cook your salmon in about 15 minutes. Bake it oven free. But the best part is unlike an oven, if you cook your salmon in an oven for too long,
yeah.
Hope the fire department's cute. In here, you can walk away and let it sit for 2 or 3 hours, and your house won't smell like fish, and it'll be delicious. So if a mother, like, has children, and she's running them around, right, she could throw the food on, turn it to low, go pick up her children, come back, instead of going through the drive-thru, and what she have for them is a delicious meal. Right? Give Corey a round of applause. Okay. Carlos, jot me down for 6 pieces of chicken and 0 oil. So if a recipe ever calls for oil, Brandy, you can leave it out. What do you guys think, in your opinion, the long-term benefits of cooking, frying without oil would be? What else? No more clogged arteries? Yeah. And what's that going to save us if we don't have clogged arteries?
Trips to the hospital.
Those are no fun. Seriously, right? No more trips to the hospital. You know, an ambulance ride is like $5,000.
Yeah.
And that's not even that good. I could get a limo for a lot less.
A lot more fun.
Yeah,
a lot more fun. Huh? Exactly.
Okay.
A lot less.
So what's next?
Cabbage.
Okay.
Three.
Cabbage number 3. So we're going to use this beautiful large skillet to cook our cabbage in. Okay. And I love this piece. I just think it's gorgeous. This is your workhorse. You can use this for an oven piece. Right? It's really awesome. So anything you do in an oven, let's say you wanted to make fish veracruz. You could bake it in here. I have a good one, huh? In about 20 minutes. You could make it like a casserole, like a chicken noodle casserole, a chicken pot pie. Just put your noodles uncooked in there, your chicken, your biscuits on top, medium quick low, done in 20 minutes. Okay? You starting to see the difference between pans and equipment? Cool, huh? What comb do I use for the cabbage? I'm sorry. Number 3. You said that. I missed it. Now, cabbage is one of those foods that's good for you. It's very alkaline. And if we keep our body alkaline, studies show disease can't live there. But it thrives. Have you guys heard that before? It thrives when we're acidic, right? So cabbage, you ever smelled it cooked? Right, I remember I was a little girl. I used to be peddling home from school, and I'd smell that smell. And I'd my bike, and I'd be like, hey, Mom! You can smell it, right? So cabbage is, when you put it at high heat, an outdated cookware, the high heat changes it from an alkaline to an acid. Mark me down for 2/3 of a head, by the way. And instead of being good for you, it becomes bad for you. Okay, who's my next chopper? Come on up. Do I want to come on? Okay. So you will not smell the cabbage cooked, and it will remain in its natural state. Which is why a lot of doctors, like Dr. Van Rogers, likes to use this, because he uses it in his healing clinic down in Tijuana, and he helps cure people of incurable diseases through food, right? So he likes this because it keeps the food in its natural state, and it can help people heal better. So this can help with ulcers, acid reflux, cancer fighter, right? Okay. So now what are we doing next, Carlos?
Carrots.
How many? Number 2. You're a good customer. Okay, Delma, so when we're using the machine, our hand's just going to be flat, and let it guide down the back. And just push down right there. She really would jump, did she? Can I get peas and corn? Pretty easy?
Yeah.
You like it?
Yeah.
Do you know the best part about it? There you go. Now thumb here, Penny, and then just push right there.
Okay.
Okay? There you go. Push right there. Then just push a little harder. There's a little bit more in there. Perfect. Awesome. Let's do 2 carrots. You guys like carrots?
Mm-hmm.
You know what carrots are good for, right?
Yeah.
You know how I know that?
Yeah.
I've never seen a rabbit wear glasses.
Yes.
Awesome. Now, how many dinners do you need? Hand back, push right there. How many dinners do you need to give away to win this?
Four.